I am Dan McKay. I am an assistant professor at University of North Carolina in Chapel Hill in the biology department and the genetics department. We're currently located in the genome sciences building. I do research trying to understand the mechanisms of gene regulation during development. I've always just been very curious about how things work. I mean, there are certain things that stick out from science camps, being a kid. I remember one year my mom brought me to some camp at the high school and we dissected owl pellets. We got these little pellets and we dissected them open and basically reconstructed whatever rodent that owl had eaten and, you know, put the bones back together. And that was, so stuff like that I always thought was cool. And after college, I got a job as a technician in a laboratory in Boston. And that really just kind of turned me on to research just immediately. A certain amount of freedom that comes along with being a scientist. You're basically your own boss in a lot of ways. You get to make decisions about how you do your experiment. You get decisions about which experiments, what area of research that you're interested in. And at this point in time, what I'm trying to do is to build a research group, recruiting graduate students and postdocs, just getting the infrastructure of the lab in place, equipment, and all the materials that we need to do our daily research. One of the powerful things about the fruit flies, I mean, they've been a model organism for over 100 years, right? So the basic idea of the gene came out of fruit fly research, right? Thomas Hunt Morgan. We can turn genes on, we can turn genes off, we can do that in a time-controlled manner, we can do that in a spatially controlled manner. So where within the animal are we removing a gene or turning it back on? But it's amazing to me that something like a fruit fly can be as powerful of a genetic model system as it is and really answer basic questions that underlie the mechanisms of human disease, right? So one of the good things about having this, they call this kind of like an open lab format, and there's basically a mixture of ideas because multiple labs are in the same space, and so we can kind of interact with each other in ways that we wouldn't if we were kind of secluded in our own separate rooms. And we get the benefit of interacting with people outside of our labs proper, but at the same time it's small enough that we have a kind of our own identity as a pod. One of the projects that I work on is trying to understand how the proteins that package your genome contribute to inheritance of traits. Three of the labs out of the four that share this space are Drosophila research labs, and this is where we do our fly pushing. So they have visible markers like curly wings or stubbly bristles, stuff like that, that we can infer their genotype based on what the adult flies look like. We work in pods. We're pod people. And so there's a series of benches that each person gets a bench to do their research. We sit next to each other. And so that's really one of the great things about doing science is that you're basically a container full of knowledge, and you get to share that with other people, and they share it with you. And so at UNC in particular is a really special place because of this collaborative atmosphere that exists. Yeah, that's one of the fun parts about the job is really the satisfaction of being able to help other people do their research. I think young people really add a lot to research, and they are substantial contributors to progress and making advances in research. The ideas oftentimes are coming from the intersection with the established folks who know the literature and know how to design experiments, and the new ideas with the young people, and that interface really is where groundbreaking science is made. And then one thing leads to another, and you keep on following down that trail.